It's Thursday, December 6th. Christian Michel, the alleged middleman in the AgustaWestland chopper deal, who was extradited from Dubai late Tuesday night, was produced before a Delhi court, which allowed the CBI 5 days of his custodial interrogation. What is the AgustaWestland bribery case? In 1999, the Indian Air Force expressed the need to replace the existing Mi-8 helicopters used for air transportation of VVIPs because its total technical life was expiring and the Mi-8 also had operational limitations. In 2002, the first request for proposal for the purchase of 12 new helicopters stipulated a mandatory altitude requirement of 6,000 meters. In other words, it said the helicopter should be able to fly at the specified high altitude. The AW101 of AgustaWestland could not be field evaluated as it was certified to fly up to an altitude of 4,572 meters only. The CBI claims that after S.P. Tyagi became the Indian Air Force Chief in 2004, he reduced the required flying height for the choppers from 6,000 meters to 4,500 meters in the revised request for proposal floated in 2006. This enabled AgustaWestland qualify. In 2010, the Ministry of Defence concluded a contract with AgustaWestland International, the UK arm of Italian company Finmeccanica, for the procurement of 12 helicopters at a total cost of 3,727 crore. In 2013, the chairman of Finmeccanica, Giuseppe Orsi, and the CEO of AgustaWestland, Bruno Spagnolini, were arrested at the behest of Italian authorities. Prosecutors accused Orsi of paying bribes to intermediaries to secure the sale of 12 helicopters in a 560 million euro deal when he was the head of the group's AgustaWestland unit. The deal was put on hold in India and a CBI probe ordered. In 2014, the UPA government cancelled the deal, citing violation of the Integrity Pact. The two men were found guilty of corruption by an Italian court. They appealed the decision. The Italian Supreme Court ordered a retrial. And in January 2018, an Italian court acquitted both, saying there isn't sufficient proof. Investigating agencies in India have maintained this will not affect the case back home. What is the role of Christian Michel? Christian Michel, Guido Haschke and Carlo Garosa are the three middlemen named by the CBI in its charge sheet. Michel, it is claimed, brokered the deal, paid bribes to politicians and officials to secure the contract for AgustaWestland. In 2016, India Today said it accessed diary notes allegedly maintained by Christian Michel that denoted payments made to individuals or entities. There were coded references such as AP and FAM with payment amounts written against them. Prosecutors had, in an Italian court, asked one of the middlemen if the AP in the note refers to Ahmed Patel, a close political aide of Sonia Gandhi. He said he didn't know. Christian Michel has claimed the note is forged, and in July this year, Michel and his sister claimed Indian investigators had offered to exonerate him if he agreed to implicate or frame Sonia Gandhi. The CBI denied the allegations. A Mumbai court has reserved its judgment in the alleged fake encounter cases of Sohrabuddin Sheikh Tulsiram Prajapati and the alleged murder of Sheikh's wife Kausarbi. A total of 92 out of the 200 witnesses examined the case turned hostile. The CBI in its final arguments had requested the court not to discard entirely the testimonies of prosecution witnesses who've turned hostile, even as the court said the CBI's theory and charge sheet are riddled with unexplained gaps. The Central Bureau of Investigation said the killings of Sohrabuddin, his wife Kausarbi and his aide Tulsiram Prajapati in 2005 and 2006 were staged, and if some defects exist in the prosecuting agency's probe, it cannot be a ground in itself to grant benefit or acquittal to the accused. Now, what is the Sohrabuddin Sheikh fake encounter case? Sheikh was shot dead in November 2005 by the Gujarat police, who claimed that he was a Lashkar-e-Taiba terrorist, A special investigation team set up by the court later found that Sheikh, his wife Kausabi, and associate Tulsiram Prajapati had actually been detained by policemen 3 days earlier when they were travelling on a bus from Hyderabad to Sangli. Sheikh's, they held, was an extrajudicial killing. Dismissing the allegation that he was a terrorist, Kausabi was also killed by the Gujarat police. A year later, Prajapati, an eyewitness in the case, was shot dead by the Gujarat police at a village near the Gujarat-Rajasthan border. 16 of the 38 accused, including Amit Shah, who was Minister of State for Home in Gujarat when the encounter took place, and IPS officer DG Vanzara, have been discharged in the case. A woman in Brazil who received a womb from a dead donor has given birth to a healthy baby girl in the first successful transplant of this kind. The recipient was born with the MRKH syndrome, a rare genetic disorder where the uterus and vagina fail to develop even though the ovary functions normally, along with the normal development of external genitalia. The donor was a 45-year-old mother of three who died of a stroke in September 2016. The transplant involved a complex connecting of veins from the donor's uterus with those of the then 32-year-old recipients, as well as linking arteries, ligaments, and vaginal canals. 5 months after the transplant, when the uterus showed no signs of rejection and the recipient was experiencing normal menstruation, the recipient's previously fertilized and frozen eggs were implanted. About 2 months later, she was confirmed pregnant, and on December 15th last year, a 2.5 kg baby was delivered by cesarean section. The medical team from Brazil's Sao Paulo University Hospital, led by Dr. Danny Eisenberg, published their findings in the Lancet Medical Journal yesterday. Earlier, experiments to transplant wombs from deceased donors in the United States, the Czech Republic, and Turkey have failed to produce a live birth, reported Al Jazeera. So far, the norm for receiving a womb has been to transplant it from a live donor. The first baby born after a live donor womb transplant was in Sweden in 2013, and the procedure has been attempted 39 times with 11 live births, reported the BBC. The number of people willing and committed to donate organs upon their own deaths are far larger than those of live donors, offering a much wider potential donor population, Al Jazeera quoted Dr. Eisenberg as saying. The procedure also applies lower costs and avoids live donor surgical risks, Dr. Sasso of the Imperial College London told BBC.
My name is Vijay Surwade. My hobby, rather a mission, is that I have collected photographs, letters, references in respect of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar since last 52 years. For collecting this material, I have traveled entire country wherever it is available. And I can say that I have got the largest collection of photographs and letters of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar in the country. My grandfather was there, my mother's father. He was very admirer of Dr. Ambedkar. He was illiterate, but he was knowing so many things. So he used to tell we children, means my brothers, my cousins, so all children, he used to tell about Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, about his education, about his revolution, about his work to nation, work of his emancipation of the untouchables, women. That curiosity increased day by day in my mind to see how our savior must be looking, how he means. I was very much impressed by his personality, and that eagerness converted into collecting photographs. So I used to go to old studios or inquiry karta tha bhai kya hai tumhara hai kya baba saab ka aisa. Then I come to know about Vir photo studio. That was on Parparel Naka. And Dr. Ambedkar's initial photographs, because he was staying in that BIT chart and his office was in Damodar Hall. So in between that, Veer studio was there on first floor. I come to know about that studio. So I went there, I contacted those people, and I collected first lot of original photographs from that studio. You must have seen the photograph of Dr. Ambedkar with his family. That is taken in 1934, near his residence at Rajra. So that photograph was taken in the studio. They had not a printed copy of that, and they were not able to trace the negative also. So what happened, one day, मैं बैठा था, देखा तो ऊपर उसमें लॉफ्ट बंद किया हुआ था, उसको छोटा सा दरवाजा था अंदर जाने के लिए, मैं सब ऊपर जब वो पोर्टमाला बोलते हैं ना, वैसा था उसमें. तो देन आई आस्क्ड दैट वर्क ऑफ उसमें क्या रखा है मैं करके, तो बोला ऐसा ही कुछ पुराने निगेटिव्स है वगैरह 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 वगैरह, जो ने स्क्रैप जैसे जो चीज़ें है वैसे वो रखी है. तो मैंने कहा कि मेरे को वो डाउट आया कि ये ढूंढने में कुछ तो मिलेगा जरूर. सो व्हाट हैपेंड देन, वी स्टार्टेड सर्चिंग देयर. Well, he agreed immediately. So what I used to do, myself and my one friend was there. So we used to go there. हम लोग practically कपड़े निकालते थे और बनियन अंडरवियर के ऊपर हम एक एक करके, because it was very suffocated there. Small room was there. So one will go up, one will stand here, and he will give something, and नीचे लाके देखने का क्या है. So we got so many photographs of this Sanyukta Maharashtra movement, labor movement, so many photographs, so many leaders, so many natak company people, Marathi drama people, so many photographs were there. Coincidentally, and there were big, even 12 by 15 size ka bhi negative the usme, 12 by 15, you imagine, wo bhi kaach ki. Achanak mere hath mein wo aa gayi, that family photograph of Dr. Ambedkar, the negative. सो मैं कह नहीं सकता कि मुझे कितनी खुशी हुई उस वक्त, जैसे अलीबाबा को गुहा मिल जाती है कोई, इस तरीके से मुझे वो फोटोग्राफ देख के लगा कि मेरे हाथ में वो फोटोग्राफ आया, देखा अरे बाप रे ग्रुप का फोटो, और नेगेटिव आप वाज ऑफ क्लास, कांच की नेगेटिव थी और उसका साइज था 12 by 15 inch. आई हैव स्पेंड मोस्ट ऑफ द मनी टाइम एंड एनर्जी एंड लेबर फॉर कलेक्टिंग ऑल दिस थिंग्स. In fact, sometimes it is injustice to my family also, I agree for that. But and in the beginning, after marriage, my wife used to complain that. Because on Saturday, Sunday also I used to go for search. So sometimes she was feeling very bad. But subsequently she came to know. And when the big people, even Sahiba Ambedkar, Phadke sir, big people used to come to my Daya Power. So then she understand that I am doing some good work, big work. I selected the photographs for my album, which will reflect the personality, personal life, events of his life, and the achievement he has achieved, and what the work he has done for the laborers, women. Workers and scheduled caste people and as a nation as a whole. So that those photographs has got a historical importance in the life of Dr. Ambedkar and in for the history also. And it will definitely a source of inspiration for the further generations to come, that they will that will always be a guiding beacon to the generations. His life itself is a great inspiration and great lesson for everybody.
And finally, YouTube's highest paid star is this 7-year-old. No kidding. Ryan of Ryan Toys Review started his channel back in March 2014 when he was 4. The views started out slow till July 2015 when Ryan's review of a giant egg surprise containing 100 toys from Pixar Cars went viral and has over 9 million views now. They aren't actual reviews. Shot at home, the videos usually feature Ryan unboxing a toy between giggles and yells as his parents urge him on from behind the camera. But it's enough to keep his audience of mostly toddlers hooked and subscribed. Ryan's earnings, calculated by Forbes to be $22 million between June 2017 and 2018, are almost completely made through pre-roll advertising. The baby tuber climbed 7 positions from being 8th on the Forbes list last year. Meanwhile, for all those above 7, we are in the business of unboxing the news. Meet us back right here tomorrow. Love your morning fix? Help support our journalism. Subscribe to Scroll Plus using the link in the description.